Let's talk about something that you talked a lot about in the early part of your presidency, stem cells. There was an order today providing federal money for embryonic stem cell research. First of all, let me just ask you, as someone who studied this, is this going to always be as divisive as an issue as it is now? Is this going to be the abortion of the next generation? Or are people going to come around?
I think the answer is I think that we'll work it through, particularly if it's done right. If it's obvious that we're not taking embryos that under any conceivable scenario would be used for a process that would allow them to be fertilized and become little babies. And I think if it's obvious that we're not talking about some science fiction cloning of human beings, then I think the American people will support this. I think they'll support it because we want to solve type 1 diabetes. We want to solve, we want to find out about whether Parkinson's and Alzheimer's can be reversed. We want, and a whole range of other things. And I think at some point, you know, maybe it's 50 decades down the way, if somebody severs an arm and you try to sew it back on and you're missing some component things, if you can figure out how to fill in the blanks here, I think people would like that. So I think we'll just have to debate it as we go along. I think that I was anxious for the president to do this and get this research going again. I don't know that I have any reservations, but he has apparently decided to leave to the relevant professional committees the definition of which frozen embryos would not be, or basically are going to be discarded because they're not going to be fertilized. I think the American people believe it's a pro-life decision to use an embryo that's frozen, that's never going to be fertilized for embryonic stem cell research, especially since now, notwithstanding some promising developments, most of the scientists in this field and the doctors will tell you they don't know of any other source that's as good as embryonic stem cells for all the various things that need to be researched. But those committees need to be really careful to make sure, if they don't want a big storm to be stirred up here, that any of the embryos that are used clearly have been placed beyond the pale of being fertilized before their use. There are large numbers of embryos that we know are never going to be fertilized, where the people who are in control of them have made that clear. The research ought to be confined to those, and I think the committees will surely do that. But that, I think, is the only area of debate that I sort of saw. I appreciated the fact that the president wants to send a strong signal that scientific research on everything from climate change to the genome to the embryonic stem cells was too politicized in the previous 8 years, and he wants to put it back to science. I agree with that. But there are values involved that we all ought to feel free to discuss in all scientific research. And that is the one thing I think these committees need to make it clear, that they're not going to fool with any embryos where there's any possibility, even if it's somewhat remote, that they could be fertilized and become human beings.
President.
Thank you.
It's our own little health summit. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
All right. Enjoyed it. Thank you.
Stand by.
Stem cell research and President Obama's recent decision. No one fought harder for this issue than Christopher Reeve. His daughter, Alexandra, is here to talk about it. We have her next on Larry King Live. Stay with us.